Challenger Joshua Pasha from Baguio City. The champion, Yosuke Tsuruta. This one brought to you by Wholesome Saludo. High up on the balls of his feet early, the champion, Tsuruta. Striking of Joshua Pasha. Pasha, the former world champion. Tsuruta, the one world champion and Shuto world champion. Back there from Tsuruta. Tsuruta starts between all points and southward here.
That's the low leg kicks of Joshua Pasha. He says he wants to attack that lower part of the leg and start kicking the calf of Tsuruta.
Now Mitch, Tsuruta isn't using that awkward, strange 90 degree angle guard we saw him use last time. Oh, turning back kick! Smacked back in the guts from Joshua Pasha.
Nice spinning back kick from Joshua Pasha. You're right, Michael, he's not utilizing that guard, but again, that's more of the mind games coming from the ninja. He doesn't want to utilize that guard, but I do think we'll see it later on in this matchup.
Overhand right from Tsuruta, outside leg, overhand right again there from Tsuruta. Chance went up for Let's Go Pasha, hit Miller.
Nice duck under to a double leg from Tsuruta as he ends up in half guard.
Pasha, receiving instructions from Mark Sanjau in the corner here from Team McGuy. Half guard position for the champion.
See, Saruka's got his head wrapped around, his left arm wrapped around the neck there, trying to get past his half guard position of Joshua Pasha. There's a choke he's got as long as Joshua Pasha holds the head in that position.
Look for finish.
Under 3 minutes remaining, first round set for five for the strawweight world title. Referee Kim Chung right on top of the action. If Pasha wins the title back, the Mall of Asia arena will melt down. To their feet, inside leg kick here from the champion. Oh, the high kick! Tried for the headache maker to Joshua Pasha.
Joshua Pasha's going head hunting early. He's already tried to go upstairs a couple of times now.
Big hello to all our fans watching on ABS-CBN Sports in Action here in the Philippines on Abima TV in Japan. Skips forward the champion. Doesn't commit though. There's a left hand from Tsuruta. Inside the Mall of Asia Arena when they chant Pasha's name. All the team of guys and all the champions are here. Flying Bellignon, Eustaquio. Also in attendance, circle side, the world's heavyweight champion, Philippine star Brandon Vera. So many luminaries have turned out in force for this night of nights in Filipino martial arts. The balls of his feet again here, Tsuruta. Inside leg kick from the champion. Still, Mitch, a filling out process from both of these two competitors.
You know, they're still kind of just, you know, there's not a lot of...
Oh, big one! The big kibosh from Tsuruta! And Pasha on the canvas, on his back there!
At the end of the filling out process, I assume.
Saruta's got some confidence flowing now. Tip has to mount it!
Pasha's got to keep it tight to get his rhythm back about it. This is where Saruta's got to create a little bit of space. I'd like to see him frame off the head and start pushing the head down. There he goes. Good scramble by Joshua.
Pasha back to his feet. The crowd appreciates that. Let's see the Russian style is now with Pasha. And he beat the champion to the straps.
Now, the first match happened about 13 weeks ago, so that's not a lot of time to make a lot of improvement. But what you can do is you can get in better shape and also figure out your game plan. Whoever can implement their game plan. Perfection tonight is going to be the one who walks with that belt.
Moving punches from Pasha. 20 seconds remains. No check there from Tsuruta. And Tsuruta taunting in the mind games from the Japanese world champion.
Tucking with the right hand there. Is that what he's doing?
Trying to get inside the head of Pasha. Sasha jumping around House King of the lead leg. But Saruta planted like a tree earlier on with that big punch.
Joshua had some early success here as he spins and goes right to the body with a beautifully timed, but then Saruta was able to answer right back with that right hand. Boom! Right on the button. Puts Pacquiao down, and then he was able to get on top and do a little bit of ground and pound. Joshua did a good job, though, of keeping Saruta nice and tight, getting his, clearing his head, and then getting right back into the match. Very interesting first round. Or should I say sixth round?
Joshua Pacquiao looking to reclaim the title that the man left of screen took from him. Instructions from Mark Sanjiao and Edward Falayang in the corner of Pacquiao.
Oh no.
Sold out inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines, the ONE Championship Roots of Honor.
Ready.
Turned out in their thousands for this one, the strawweight world title. Will it be a Filipino victory? Good two-punch combination off the bell there for Pacquiao. Switching stance, Saruta. AEG veteran. Has all the tricks in the book, and some that aren't even written in the book. Pacquiao. Looks to get airborne with that knee, but didn't commit to it, didn't have the distancing.
Action!
Saruta inside leg kick. High kick from Pacquiao. He's enjoying that high right roundhouse tonight. Hasn't really found success with it, though.
He was expecting to throw that roundhouse kick off of the awkward guard shown by Saruta, and Saruta hasn't shown him that guard yet. Again, more of that veteran mind game move as Pacquiao.
Getting back this from Saruta, a counter punch from Pacquiao, accidentally hit the back of the head. Apologies there, good sportsmanship. The media attention on this bout, on this entire card, has been crazy. Our media conference at City of Dreams earlier on in the week was a record attendance, some 500 plus media members, the biggest in history. All over the news and Team Lakai. Athletes appearing on CNN Philippines earlier this week. Outside leg kick there from Saruta. Manila really is a hotbed for ONE Championship. Indeed, this entire combat crazy nation love ONE Championship, especially when it comes to town. It was in Saruta's town a couple of weeks ago in Tokyo. Falayang saw the title lost against Shinya Aoki, who put him to sleep in the first round. And in the early team, the guys' titles were gone. It's now the responsibility of Pacquiao to win one back for the men from Baguio City.
Good movement shown by Saruta, but as soon as Saruta stopped and got a stationary stance, that's when Pacquiao spun and landed another spinning back kick. I think this movement's kind of got Joshua Pacquiao a little bit confused here in the second as he marches forward and throws a big right hand there from Saruta.
Haven't really seen Pacquiao open up with his wushu, with the striking, the combinations. Has had some acrobatics, turning back kicks and jumping roundhouse kicks. Nothing that's landed effective telling blows on Saruta so far. Another agonizingly close rear leg roundhouse kick. Left hand followed by right there by Saruta.
Saruta close to that distance, incredibly fast with that lightning fast footwork, how he's in and out of there. And Pacquiao seems to have a hard time getting into the rhythm.
Lots of angles being cut here from Saruta.
Like that strategy employed by Saruta, not to stay still as he ducks under a big head kick there.
Certainly, Pacquiao is going for that head kick time and time again. And there's the first show of that strange forearm guard that Saruta did last time that confounded Pacquiao. Oh, overhand right from Saruta, tried for the counter.
Marshall said he didn't want to spin as much as he did in the first time because you can start to see that Saluka started to time that. He started to step to the outside right as Pashiao was spinning. And that's the same mistake that Foliang made with Nguyen. Nguyen saw it coming over and over again, and he started to step to the side. And then what happened? Boom, a big overhand right that caught Foliang mid-spin. Pashiao's got to be careful with this spinning.
Leg kick there from Saruta, which went high on the thigh, but do you think they're both going to hold him back a little here? We haven't really seen them put the foot down to the gas.
Well, in the second round, they're still, you know, they're still trying to get a bearing on each other. I don't think Pashiao expected Saruta to A, come out in this stance, B, this mobile, and I think the Saruta is a little bit surprised at the inactivity coming back from Pashiao, because Pashiao said he did not want to wait, he did not want to hesitate. Last 10 seconds
of a break off there from Saruta. Final few seconds of this round. High kick from Pashiao. Two rounds down, set for five. Strawweight world title on the line. Saruta versus Pashiao from inside the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila.
Second round was more of a feeling out process than the first round. We got to see that big right hand from Saruta in the first and a couple of spinning back kicks throughout the course of this match so far coming from Pashiao. But what kind of changes are we going to make? I'd like to see Pashiao start attacking that lower leg, slow down the movement of Saruta, just start hammering on that calf, which is something he said he wanted to do. Start putting the punches in the face of Saruta. I like how Saruta in the first round was mixing things in with the takedowns. I'd like to see him throw hands, close that distance, and start at least giving Pashiao something else to think about besides just the striking. Get into his head a little bit more. Throw those takedowns in.
Come here.
Third round of five. Wherever you're watching, in 140 countries around the world, we hope you're enjoying it. That's one championship, Roots of Honor.
Ken Chang had the same concern we did, and he urged the guys to show a little bit more activity in the third round.
Jab from Saruta. Roundhouse kick from Pashiao, just tucked under the left arm. Thrust out the jab to the Filipino. Body shot, stuck it well, belly button through the back.
Pashiao likes that technique. He likes to go high with the roundhouse and then follow it up with a spinning back kick. He was able to drop Roy Deliguez back in 2017 in the second round with a beautiful spinning back fist off of that roundhouse kick.
Let's see if Pashiao can work those wushu kicking skills of his. Lots of movement here from Yasuke Saruta. Saruta, the current world champion. Pashiao, the former world champion. Overhand right there from Pashiao.
Saruta is still the owner of the biggest punch so far in this match with that big overhand right that happened in the first. Nice leg kick there by Pashiao.
Two-punch combination from Pashiao. Backs off Saruta.
You start to see the superficial damage on the lower leg of Pashiao starting to welt up there from that one kick. They're starting to mix and things in with the takedowns. Skip the takedown. Now he's trying to pass the guard. Nice elevation there from Pashiao to get back to his feet.
Crowd momentarily thought that Pashiao had a choke locked onto the champion.
But I like the strategy from Saruta. Mix in the takedowns. Get Pashiao thinking about that. At least start fearing it so he doesn't start to throw, so he doesn't get so comfortable with the stand-up.
Pashiao fainting. So too Saruta. Razor thin, this world title matchup at the moment. Angles again from Saruta, the cagey one. Pashiao trying to counter. Inside leg from Saruta. Good jab, no right hand for company though. Back in, looking for the lever of Saruta. It's a Team Lakai specialty.
And shoot.
The impact of the lever.
Final warning.
Very large target. Just to the right of the stomach there. impact of vagus nerve closed down the entire body. I say one of the most painful ways, if not the most painful way to get knocked out, is with a liver strike. Particularly a liver punch where you're driving the knuckles up in between the 9th and 10th ribs. Turning back into the liver, will do just as well. Overhand right, the cranium cracker there from Pastia. Just needed a little bit more mustard behind it. Outside leg kick. Now Pastia starting to land some heavier strikes, Dragon.
He is, he's starting to put together those kicks with a little bit more of the punches as well. He's throwing combinations, he's getting a little more comfortable.
Turning back in though. Man.
That time Soju was able to step to the side of it. He's starting to see it coming. The problem is when he steps to the side, he's able to avoid it. But when he goes back, he tries to ride the wave of that kick to it, kind of take away some of the pressure from it. I don't think it's hurting him so much, but it's scoring in the mind of the judges. Also, the score sheets.
1:15 remains. Don't forget we are scoring an overall bout, not round by round, under these one championship global rule sets. High kick again from Pascio. Saruta leans back in evasion. Left hook from the champion.
In the third round.
Joy for the crowd as Pascio again bound up and spun on Saruta. You expect a little bit more action from Saruta.
I did, especially in this third round. He started the first round off very effectively, and then he's kind of gone slowed down as the matches went on. But Pascio is not really doing as much as I thought he would do either. He's landed a few beautiful side kicks, and that's really been the most significant strike of this round. I do like the takedown that Saruta has to be getting.
Hand right there from Pascio. Inside leg goes Saruta. Final seconds of the third and five. Two more rounds to go here in Manila for the one strawweight world title.
Man, these guys have been in the ring, the circle, for 40 minutes together. They have a really good read on what to expect. And so they know each other very, very well. So don't get caught too much in this slow action. But we're seeing a lot of very technical details starting to inch forward, especially now that we hit the championship rounds again. This is round, essentially, this is going to be round 9 between these two. Like Sukasha, do more of it. Be more active. Start throwing those hands. Start putting the pressure on Saruta. Back him up. I want to see Saruta mix in more takedowns. Start throwing a little more feet with the punches. Backing Pascio up and then shooting him for those takedowns. Very close match so far.
You see the ice being applied there by former world champion Edward Filiac. 130 martial arts world champions on the one championship roster. Two of them in the circle at the moment. Let's see for some more pepper, some more get up and go. Saruta body punches here from Pascio. Saruta turns him around against the fence and drives the corky knees into the thighs. Pascio turns the champion.
Placing the hand there on the knee to stop any retaliation from the knees from Pascio.
Shot from Pascio, got in quick, got out even quicker. High kick from Saruta. Pascio to stab himself in center circle here. Cross out the jab. Saruta does have some damage under the right eye, courtesy of that lead hand of Pascio. On the lead thigh and shin calf area of Pascio, courtesy of the leg kicks for the champion. There's another one. Fourth round of five. Jab to Pascio. Kim Mitchell gets in quick and scores, gets out.
Pascio, we expected to see, those fast blitzes, bop bop, in and out. So we're just kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Each of the Metro's stepped right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful kick there from Saruta. Landed on Saruta. That big first round knockdown, but now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pashao starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think the striking superiority's there.
From Saruta, under 3 minutes remains, penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Saruta do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pashao. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pashao. Now all he's doing now is just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lakai athlete.
To present the belt for this match, we have CEO and President Philippines of Pulsing, Mr. John Stowe. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kim Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 43 seconds in the fourth round for your winner by way of knockout!
Once again, has a world title belt in its possession.